I will sketch four common mechanical parts in this video. This first part is a common revolved flange. Although simple, it will demonstrate what I mean by sketching closed shapes. This part is a symmetrical frame that mounts an electrical rocker switch in an assembly. The third example is an open-ended wrench. There are several videos on the internet showing how to sketch a wrench like this. Let me show you a simple way to do it by thinking about the functional shapes. This last part is a typical training part I saw used in an instructional video. Let me show you the hard way and then the easy way to sketch this shape. Let me introduce the magic of closed shapes. These include three kinds of rectangles. First, a rectangle by two points. If you start at a known point, this shape only takes two dimensions to fully constrain it. Next, use the rectangle by three points to create a rectangle at an angle. This shape will require three dimensions, including the angle. Use a centered rectangle as the basis for symmetric parts. Only two dimensions are required to fully constrain a symmetric rectangle. Let's edit the parameters to show how the rectangle maintains symmetry. A full circle is another useful closed shape. It only requires one dimension. A polygon requires two dimensions. Here I make one edge parallel with an axis and create one dimension to fully constrain the hexagon. These shapes are powerful because they automatically contain all the constraints they need to maintain their shape. You don't have to think about it. Let's start a new sketch to create the revolved flange. The traditional way to create this is with the profile command. I start with a horizontal line to align the shape with the origin, and then continue around the shape by carefully clicking. All the geometric constraints are created. I then add dimensions. Oops. So let me start over to show you an even easier way. I start the same way with the horizontal line. But now I click two rectangles. The shape takes seven clicks with the profile command, but with rectangles it only takes four clicks, two clicks for the diagonal of each rectangle. This method guarantees that all the lines are horizontal, vertical, and perpendicular, because that comes for free with the rectangle. So all I need to do is finish these dimensions and then check that the sketch is fully constrained. So you can see now the sketch is fully constrained. I am purposely leaving the alignment line and the overlapping line between the rectangles to show another piece of magic. With the sketch feature selected, I click Revolve and pick the axis. Let me temporarily turn off timestamp order to show that even though the sketch was an open line and two closed shapes, the result is one solid body. For my second example, I am using the rocker switch holder from this assembly. The inner dimensions of this part must fit around the rectangle of the switch. So let me create a new part to show this model from scratch. I create a sketch on the default XY plane. The first shape I sketch is a centered rectangle. And I'll dimension it to match the switch dimensions. I next sketch a frame around the first rectangle using another centered rectangle. Then I sketch another centered rectangle for the mounting ears. I add an arc and a circle. And then I mirror them. Let's finish up with the remaining dimensions. Again, I check that the part is fully constrained. I am purposely not trimming the sketch because this will cancel the magic of the closed shapes and can delete some of the constraints. With the sketch selected, watch the magic when I click Extrude. Again, I'll temporarily turn off timestamp order to show that there is only one solid body. All right, how does this method work with this wrench example? Let me again start from scratch with a new part. I'll start a new sketch on the default XY plane. The purpose of a wrench is to fit around a hexagonal fastener. So let me start the design by sketching a hexagon to represent the fastener we are designing the wrench to fit. I dimension the angle to 15 degrees, so you can turn the wrench upside down to get a different angle on the fastener. Next, I will dimension the hexagon to 10 millimeters, a standard metric fastener size. Notice that the sketch is now fully constrained. I sketch a line across the hexagon and create a circle centered on the line. Let me name the 10 millimeter dimension size 1. I will then make the diameter of the circle twice the wrench size. I will draw an arc around 3 points of the hexagon to form the shape of the back of the wrench. I will add a 3-point rectangle to extend the opening of the wrench. I will match the length of this rectangle to the size so that as I change the wrench size, the rectangle will always be big enough. Notice that the sketch is fully constrained. With the sketch selected, I click Extrude. This time the magic selection does not work. So instead, I extrude and manually select the curve rule of region boundary curves and select the one region I want to extrude. I choose a symmetric end limit. I will leave finishing the handle and the other end of the wrench to another day. This last example is the kind that can give sketching a reputation as being difficult. It looks simple, but the constraints can become quite complex. Let's start with a new part and sketch on the XY plane. Let me start off the hard way. I'll sketch the inner circle, and then I'll use the profile command to sketch the outer boundary. So I'll click around the boundary, sketching about the shape that's desired. And click and drag to make an arc. Already some of the auto dimensions are confusing. Let's first constrain the circle and arc to be concentric. Let's add a perpendicular constraint to the end of the leg here. And a parallel constraint between the sides. Next, I will use the make symmetric command. Well, that was symmetric, but not what I wanted, so I will undo. This can be done, but let me start over now to show you the easy magic method. I will start with the two circles centered on the origin and dimension them to the required values. The next shape I see is a rectangle for the center portion. I sketch a rectangle and drag the center point to constrain it. Then I drag a corner point to constrain to the circle. The legs of the shape are angled rectangles, so I will use a rectangle by 3 points. I will mirror this entire shape to create the other leg. Now I add the remaining dimensions, starting with the angle of the legs and then the width of the legs. Two more dimensions completes the entire sketch. Okay, and notice now the sketch is fully constrained. Notice that each rectangle internally contained parallel and perpendicular constraints, so I didn't have to think about it. With the sketch selected, I tried the magic method. In this case, it missed two regions. So all I need to do is use region boundary curves and select the two additional regions. And here's the finished part. In summary, there are three important things to remember. Use closed shapes to sketch whenever you can. Start with the shapes that define the function of the part. Second, don't trim the sketch. Third, extrude by selecting the sketch before the extrude command. If that doesn't work, use the curve rule of region boundary curves. Thanks for sticking with me. I hope this can help you make better use of NX sketching.